Hello and welcome to OptinMonster. Our campaign builder makes it easy to add a close button or link to your pop-up type campaigns. In this video, I'll show you three different ways to add a close button or link in OptinMonster. But first, if you haven't done so already, be sure to hit that subscribe button and notification bell. Now, let's get started. So I've just finished designing my campaign, and now I simply need to configure the close button options. The first method involves using and styling the close button that's already built right into OptinMonster. Simply select it to open the styling options in the settings panel. By default, the display a close button option is toggled on. Here, you can change the X color, the background color, and the button style. In the advanced tab, you can set different colors for the hover state. You can also change the position, size, thickness, shadow, and spacing of the button as well. Alright, this looks good, but I want to do something a little different for the success view of my campaign, so let's head over there now. On this view, I have a button that allows my visitor to head directly over to the store to start shopping. But my visitor might not be ready to leave this page just yet. So, instead of the built-in close button on this view, I want to add a button below the Start Shopping button that allows the visitor to close this campaign and continue reading the blog post they were just viewing. As you can see, the changes I made to the close button in the opt-in view carried over to the success view. To disable the built-in close button on this view, I'll simply select the close button, and then under view styling, I'll toggle the global view styling option off. Now, a quick note, you want to be sure that you're finished making any global changes to your campaign before disabling the global view styling. After disabling the global view styling setting, any changes you make to one view that you also want to appear in another view will have to be done individually in each of those views. Now that I've disabled the global view styling, I can disable the built-in close button for the success view. Then, I can navigate back to the blocks menu and drag and drop a button element onto my campaign just below the Start Shopping button. I'll change the button text to Let Me Finish Reading, and then in the button click action menu, select Close the Campaign. When my visitor clicks this button, they will be returned to the blog post they were just reading. Alright, the third option is adding a close link to the campaign instead of a button, and this is for those of you who don't mind working with a little HTML and CSS. First, I'll remove the button I just added, and then drag and drop an HTML block element onto my campaign. Next, in the Content tab, I'll need to add an HTML link containing the class om-trigger-close into the HTML field. And to make the link look nice and match the design of my campaign, I'll need to add some CSS here in the CSS editor. Then I just need to save my changes, publish my campaign, and that's it. If you have any questions, browse through our helpful documentation. Or for further assistance, you can submit a support ticket and we'd be happy to help.